पल कर गई चुल
That was a rocking performance from our judges, the Dashin Jeffrey Iqbal, the ever gorgeous Dr. Vindhya Prasad, and the charming Purnash Durga Prasad. They definitely set the stage on fire. Judges, are you ready for the first elimination round?
I think so. It's not the easiest part, but yes.
I'm quite ready. I think I've been dying to hear what the participants will sing, and I know that the audience is just, you know, waiting.
I'm excited to be back in Guyana. Last year was amazing. I have a feeling this year is going to be awesome. I'm not looking forward to the whole elimination part of it, but I'm definitely looking forward to some awesome music. We've got an awesome cast, we got great musicians, and it's going to be dope. So get ready for Emerging Voices Season 2. It's going to be killer.
Thank you, judges. It's time to take your seats now. A round of applause for our judges. Hey guys, I'm Taruna Tiwari, and it's my pleasure to welcome you to another episode of Emerging Voices Season 2. Our 18 finalists are from across Guyana, and they'll have to prove that they've got what it takes to win the competition. The finalists of Emerging Voices Season 2. Our participants will be divided into two groups, Team A and Team B. Tonight, only 17 of our participants are here, and here is why.
I was pushing in the gate. It's a big, long, rolling steel gate. And when I was pushing in the gate, the whole gate fell on me, and I was on the ground, lying, like, not really unconscious, but they had to rush me to the hospital. I feel very sad right now because of the situation I'm in, but I want to get better as soon as possible to go work back with them because they're two very nice fellows to work with. I don't think this will affect the performance because after the first season, I saw it on the television and I said to myself, now I was waiting for this opportunity to be in this E-Network's Emerging Voices competition this time around.
Hale hale zindagi ko ab tere hawale karo.
I remember seeing him in the audition. He wore this really bright orange shirt,
right.
And you know, he's ready for his audition. He was all, you know, set, and he came on, and you know, we were just making fun of him, and he was taking all the jokes. He was such a cool guy, lighthearted, you know, and he sang really well, you know, and I told him, hey, we got to see you on this show, so I'm looking forward to seeing him for sure.
You know, we were all worried. First and foremost, we wanted to make sure that he was okay, and now that we know that he is, that's great. When you have that drive, it can sometimes surpass talent.
Right.
So, unfortunately, he isn't here with us today, but I think that we should give him a chance if there is a possibility to bring him in for the next round.
So, for all of us, Taruna, he's in, and he comes in the second round.
Thank you so much for your comforting words and for allowing him to get on to the next round. I'd like to invite Team A to be seated over there in their seats. I'd also like to invite Team B to sit in audience tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, join me and let's welcome Shivanand Singh.
Mere dil ne chun laya
must have been hearing a lot of things over these years. Yeah? Well, I'm glad you stepped out of the bathroom and onto the stage, because I really, really like your voice.
Thanks,
and you know, I think, yes, yes, and yes. Pranash?
Thanks a lot.
Shivanand.
Yes, sir.
You just killed it on stage, man, just now. That was that was so explosive just now, especially when you go into that bridge. When you went over to that bridge, it was all the energy we wanted in the song.
Yes, thanks, sir.
You did it really well, man.
Thank you.
Keep it up.
I just have nothing to do but give you thumbs up from here and here.
Yeah, thanks,
man.
The excitement here is overwhelming, and I hate to leave you in suspense, but it is time for a break. Keep watching. We'll be right back with Emerging Voices Season 2.
Celebrate life, celebrate taste, enjoy the flavor, no time to waste. Enjoy the way it rolls on your tongue, enjoy the smooth way it goes down. I seal it with joy, celebrate and enjoy. 14 flavors, different shirt thirds, when you feel the heat, reach for icy first pineapple, big red ginger, and banana, tangerine, bubblegum, orange and cream soda, mango, green crush, fruit, button, beer, grapefruit, passion fruit. Let you know it's time to celebrate. I see. Celebrate and enjoy.
Boasting 24 karat gold and the finest handmade crafts, King's Jewelry World remains Guyana's top jeweler, attracting interest from all over the world.
As you know, the quality of gold in Guyana is very high. The availability, the abundance of gold has made it an excellent opportunity to share with the rest of the world. Our craftsmen have been using the same techniques that they would have brought centuries ago, and it's the love and the handmade aspect of the jewelry that we have that makes it stand out from the rest of the world.
The desire to create a product that not only leaves an impression, but which tells a story is the very quality that distinguishes King's Jewelry World as the premier choice. Be a part of something great.
Welcome to Guyana, and I encourage you to visit King's Jewelry World, manufacturers of Guyana's gold, and be sure to take home a piece of Guyana's gold, world renowned.
King's Jewelry World, located in Georgetown at Quamina Street and Middle Street, at Giflin Mall, and duty-free shop at Chetty Jargons International Airport. Visit any of our locations today. This Christmas, be timeless and create your own story.
Hi, I'm Chelsea Edgel, your National Honor 21 and Women's Champion 2016. And when I'm off the court, I drink the juice of champions, Sunburst.
Sunburst Juice is manufactured by Continental Foods Inc.
Our next participant on tonight's show is Andy Rutan. This contestant had a hidden talent, and he's not allowing anybody to stop him. Jeffrey, you've made a promise to Andy. I'd like to welcome you on stage. Did you speak to his parents?
No, I haven't yet. I didn't know what the situation was at home. I didn't hear anything yet.
Okay, this is your moment now. I'd like you to fulfill the promise that you've made to Andy during the auditions.
Put your mama's number in my phone.
Hello?
Hello?
Hey.
Hi, is this...
Good night.
Hi, good night.
Good night.
Is this Savitri auntie?
Savitri.
Savitri.
Yes.
Yes. Auntie. Hi, my name is Jeffrey Iqbal. I'm calling from Emerging Voices.
Okay. Emerging Voices.
Yeah, do you know what Emerging Voices is?
No.
It's basically Guyana's biggest singing platform for aspiring singers, specifically for Bollywood music. And I have someone here that's super, super close to you. You might know him. He's your son?
My son?
Yeah, your son, Andy.
Andy?
So,
I don't know. You're kidding me? Andy is there?
Yeah, where is he supposed to be?
He's supposed to be at work soon, coming home.
Well, I have to break some news to you, and I don't know if you're going to find this to be great news or not so great news, but from me, this is amazing news. Andy had came in, and he had auditioned for a spot to be on our television show, Emerging Voices, and among hundreds of people around the country, he was selected to be on this television show and represent your family and himself in front of the whole country. So we actually have him on set right now, and there's cameras everywhere. And your boy is about to be a star.
Oh my God. Can I have a word with Andy?
Yeah, so I just wanted to call you because Andy was telling me that he was a little scared, and he knew that people from the temple were supporting him, but he wasn't sure how everyone at home felt.
Oh boy.
He's here right now if you want to talk to him.
Oh, let me speak to him 1 minute, please.
Yeah.
Hi, Mom.
Yes, Andy, what are you doing there? What are you doing there, Andy?
Mom, I'm sorry, but this is my dream, and this is what I want to do, but all I need is your support.
Oh, my God. I am dealing with you. I'm going to deal with you when you come home. You're supposed to let me know where you're going.
I told you guys don't call her, and then...
I mean, so basically he's making you a deal from what I understand. It seems like he's saying that he has a specific career route that you want. Is it what do you wish for Andy? If you had a dream for Andy, what's your dream for Andy?
Well, my dream for him, what he desire. He loves music, but I didn't want him to go into music because, you know, music doesn't have nothing in this country.
But, you know? I know it seems that way, and I'm kind of a part of a similar story. I was born and raised in America where there's absolutely no Bollywood. And my parents were all about me being a part of the family business and doing all sorts of stuff and being very, very corporate.
But you have 1 minute remaining.
Hello? So I'm going to make this really short.
What?
Okay, real quick, Auntie, I'm gonna tell you something. I think you need to come on set and see what Andy's capable of. This guy is unbelievably talented. We have a lot of faith in him. I can guarantee you one thing. This guy can do two things at once.
I'll try.
Keep trying, Auntie. Keep trying.
Your
and come on the set one day. I'm gonna show you something amazing.
The call will be disconnected.
This call has been disconnected. Saved by the bell, my man.
Thank you so much. Oh my God.
Round of applause for Andy!
Sa 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 sa
before I say anything. Audience, what did you guys think? Well, they liked it, which is great. I liked it too. And you know, there's a specific thing that you and I have because we're trying to get your mom to support you. So I'm kind of rooting for you big time, man. So this is what I need from you. I need you to fight.
I thought there were some parts that needed a little work, but what you had going for you from the moment you opened your mouth was a lot of soul. And I think that connected with me, and definitely from the response of the audience, that connected with them.
Thank you so
you
much.
You had a lot of soul. And I think when you have that kind of soul in your voice, that's a big factor. So I want to say, you know, keep working on those little difficult bits, keep practicing, and definitely, I think without us even asking, your mom will say, Andy, I think this is what you must do. Follow your dream. So
thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Pranash?
So Andy, how did you feel during the performance?
It was awesome. I came out here, I did what I had to do, I did my best, and you know, this is it.
Okay, well, you know, sometimes, you know, we can want something so bad, you know? We can want something so bad that sometimes we try to bring it all one time. And I feel like that's what happened. You got a little overwhelmed, and you were, some of the parts that you were singing before, whenever the music was rolling, you're constantly thinking ahead, and you're not taking time to be in the moment of every verse, every line by line. And because of that, what happens is that you get nervous, and what happens, you tend to breathe in the wrong places. And some places you were missing because you were breathing in the wrong places, you weren't taking enough breath. But other than that, you know, the soul in your voice is there. You know, so that means, you know, the next one's got to be a little stronger, for sure.
Thank you.
All right?
So much.
Keep it up.
It is time for a break. Keep watching. We'll be right back with Emerging Voices Season 2.
Sujata curry powder is a unique and exotic blend of spices from the Asian continent. Sujata curry powder contains a high percentage of turmeric, which is high in antioxidants and good for your body. Manufactured by Continental Industries Limited and available countrywide. Sujata curry powder, where the taste speaks for itself.
Hi, I'm Chelsea Edgel, your National Honor 21 and Women's Champion 2016. And when I'm off the court, I drink the juice of champions, Sunburst.
Sunburst Juice is manufactured by Continental Foods Inc.
Is Vidya Ram. She's a 26-year-old microbiologist who's passionate about making a difference in her field. For Vidya, music is life, and she loves singing. Let's welcome Vidya Ram.
think I'm going to say to you tonight?
You did a good job.
You sure?
Positive.
Well, actually, no, that wasn't what I was going to say.
Okay.
You're really way off base there. Actually, what I'm going to say is you did a terrific job tonight. I loved it. I loved it.
Oh,
I really loved it.
Thank you.
It's one of the songs that I like. I really, really loved it. I think you really surprised me. You put a lot of, you know, heart into that. I felt it. And you got all those little bits just right throughout the song. So well done.
Thank you. But you, I almost got a heart attack. But thanks God.
Don't worry. I'm going to come and done some resuscitation.
Vidya.
Yes.
I really enjoyed that one just now.
Thank you.
It was perfect. It was sweet. It was soft. It was loud when it needed to be. And you really, you know, went with all the dynamics. Whenever the band was coming up, you're also coming up at the same time. Good job.
Thank you.
So I want to give you an extra like because you did better here on stage than you've ever done in practice, and I've gotten a chance to hear you before. So you were much more calm. You seemed much more composed. You sang it sweeter. It was dynamic. It was a more dynamic performance than what I was expecting. So awesome.
Thumbs up.
Well done.
Thank you.
After losing two friends, Maya is on the journey to raise the level of awareness about suicide.
We've heard of a lot of stories, not in our village, but in different village, about suicide, and somehow this just happened to catch my attention.
Approximately 3 years we have started the workshop on suicide, whereby we've educated a group of young pioneers. Normally it can be once a month, sometimes once every 2 months. So gradually over the years she has grown, and because when she completed school, that's when I decided that, you know what, this is the time that I can actually break her into this as well.
I've had a few friends that think about it, and I've lost a friend due to suicide. They had no reason for him. Nobody ever find a reason why he committed suicide. Nobody ever know that he had a problem because he didn't have no sign saying that he would commit suicide or anything like that. The funeral, I don't think I could have handled his funeral. It was too sad for me to be there. So instead I just stay right at home and I call his sisters and I try to console them and they try to console me. And from then I start moving on and getting serious with suicide because this is a serious matter. Even the happiest person on earth could commit suicide. That's what I learned.
So since Maya joined the Suicide Vishnu Mandir approximately 10 years ago, she had been an ordinary singer, just singing along in choruses and everything. But after listening to her beautiful voice, we made her start singing with the mic. And she has moved and elevated herself as one of the leading singers on the Upper East Bank.
Maya, I was looking at that with a lot of interest. As you know, I've been doing a lot of work myself dealing with suicide, and it is a problem in Guyana. We have the highest rate in the world. And I'm very happy that you're taking this step and you're doing something in your community, because this is the kind of thing that we need, that everyone looks out for everyone else and gets involved, and we don't see it as only a problem for some. We see it as a problem for everyone.
At some phase in life, you know, depression happens, but if you were to talk to anyone, if you were to tell people at home, if anyone has ever had these kind of thoughts, if anyone's ever felt this way, has ever considered taking their life, is there something that you would like to say to them?
Don't believe that every day is a dark day. There is a bright day out there for you. Just have patience and wait. Your sunshine is about to come.
Yeah.
issue was it seemed like you were unsure. You didn't know when to come in. You didn't know when to come out. And there were certain notes that were falling short that, you know, there's something called center pitch. And if you're below center pitch, you're called flat. If you're above center pitch, you're called sharp. And you were kind of falling flat a lot. And that was taking it away from me. That those moments were kind of holding me back from really enjoying it. So, I mean, I did give you some likes. There were moments that you did, like, there were certain ways that you delivered certain words that I really appreciated. So there are good points to it, but I want you to be aware of those points that you need to work a little harder on.
Maya, you have some good things going for you. One is that you have a really, really nice voice. But I think in this song, I did not get to appreciate the voice completely. That it could have been better, but I have to agree with Jeffrey. A lot of it was flat. For me, the last bit of it got stronger, but when you did the verse, there were a lot of notes that you weren't hitting. You were a little unsure of the melody. So I wanted to hear, this song has a lot of highs and lows in it, and I wanted to hear that in the song. But as I said, you have a lot of positives, and one of those things, you're either gifted with it or you're not. And that's a beautiful voice, and you do have a beautiful and a very different voice. And if you use that voice in the correct way, I think you'll definitely go far.
Well, Maya, I kind of have a soft spot for you in this situation here because I know, you know, what it's like, you know, you do most of your music in Mandir, right? And what happens in Mandir, you know, I'm always playing harmonium in temple. So, you know, you play this nice little interlude and some auntie just come in. You know, they don't care when they come in. They come in when they want, start, stop, anytime they want. So they don't really pay attention to when the music is coming and when they'll actually start the verse. And I know you were thinking about it a lot. You were like, hey, you're counting in your head four bars. You know, I have to come in. And that's, I guess, I understand what you were doing. And that's what took away a little bit, you know, from your performance. But other than that, I like that you're thinking about the math and you're, you know, you're planning your performance. But besides that, like Jeffrey said, you have to bring the rest. Right? Let's keep it up.
Thank you. It is time for a break. Keep watching. We'll be right back with Emerging Voices Season 2.
It feels good in my heart, in my soul, in the here right beside me. I will never let this day to end.
Something smells good in that kitchen.
Now, I don't know about the rest of you, but I gonna find out why it's a secret to a legendary curry chicken.
You're waiting for me. Mm-hmm. Can I help you, girl?
Girl, you know Linda Fass. She wondering what makes your curry the most talked about in town.
It's no secret, ladies. It's Sujata.
Oh, Sujata.
I'd like to call our next contestant. She comes all the way from Parika. Apart from being new to motherhood, Trisha Pasad, with the support of her husband, plans to wow the judges during the season of Emerging Voices. Let's welcome Trisha Pasad.
इनका तो पन्ना है सिंपल सा यार गोली मारो
You don't look like you're quite sure of what happened there.
At the ending, yes.
Yeah, what happened there?
I wouldn't blame it on the baby. It was me. I the breath was not...
Well, that's something I actually wanted to comment on because, and I want to give you, you know, one more just for that because throughout the song, your breathing was quite good. You were able to hold the notes. You were able to give the repetitive words. I know at the end it got a little tough for you, but you plowed on.
Just like Vindi just said, I think the breathing did catch up to you at the end. You know, once you missed that one line, I know exactly what happened. When you were coming in from the second verse, you forgot to breathe. And then after that, it was like a spiral all the way down to the end.
Yeah.
But other than that, it was rocking, good energy.
Thank you.
Awesome.
You did better than I anticipated, which is good. The ending was... sadly, an epic fail. I don't know what happened. Like, you is as if you kind of lost your way.
Yeah.
Everything was going really well, but the end just kind of went.
The excitement here is overwhelming, and I hate to leave you in suspense, but it is time for a break. Keep watching. We'll be right back with Emerging Voices Season 2.
Hi, Giano. I'm Noem. I'm Danny, the national badminton champion.
When I'm off the court, I drink the juice of champions. Sunburst.
Sunburst juice, available in 9 great flavors, manufactured by Continental Foods, Inc., and available at all supermarkets, wholesale depot, and retail outlets nationwide.
Good in that kitchen. Now, I don't know about the rest of you, but I want to find out why it's for your secret to a legendary curry chicken.
You're waiting for me. Can I help you, girl?
Girl, you know Linda Fast. She's wondering what makes your curry the most talked about in town.
It's no secret, ladies. It's Sujata.
Oh, Sujata.
This 35-year-old husband and father is not giving up on his dreams on becoming a professional singer. Let's welcome Riaz Rafiq.
Hey.
मोहब्बत का गम है ये जितना कम है ये तो जमाना नहीं जान पाएगा मेरा जो सनम है जरा बेरहम है देखे मुझे वो दर्द मुस्कुराएगा दिल को ऐसे दिल भर से भी नाज होता है ओ किसी से तुम
That was rocking, man. That was really good. I feel like you're on the stage. You're not even on the competition. You look so confident, and you got a lot of energy, and you're having fun, and that's what it's all about.
Yep.
You know, you remind me of Kumar Sanu. I feel like you got that type of voice texture, you know, there. And I know you're probably a Kumar Sanu fan, are you?
Of course, yes.
All right. Keep it up, buddy.
Riaz, you bring a lot of energy in your performance. You have a big voice. And what I liked, you were very chill about the performance. Okay. Very, very chill about it. And what the point I would like to give you, though, is on the endings of your words. I'm hearing when you breathe at the end of the line. So I think you need to work a little bit on the breathing techniques when you sing. But I thought it was a really, really nice performance. I enjoyed it, and I think you connected.
I'm pretty sure, and Purnaj will correct me because he knows the song better than I do, but I believe that the verse goes, ba-da-da-da-da-da, da-da-da-da-da-da, and you didn't hit any of those notes. Da, da, that whole sliding thing needs to happen. And you kind of skipped a couple notes and you went down to the bottom. So we got likes, but that was because the band was killing it and the song is fun. But I want you to pay attention to those parts because there may be people out there that heard the song and thought it was amazing, but it wasn't exactly the way it should have been.
Okay.
But you sounded good still nonetheless, man. Don't take my negative comments as you did terribly. You did a good job, but it definitely could have been better.
He's just 21 years old and has a passion for singing, and he's also a pandit. Let's welcome Dharmraj Mahabir.
कुछ भी नहीं है आगे तो
Puniji, Jayaramji ji. Kya baat hai, very nice. That was a great performance. It was smooth. All your transitions were good. Your pronunciation, of course. Very good job.
Thank you. Keep it up.
I will say, you know, awesome. Pretty awesome. And that's a song I really, really
awesome.
Like. Keep going.
I'm just going to not speak for this one.
Okay.
Thanks a lot.
Awesome. Our next contestant is Sashruti Devi Harichan. Sashruti can be considered a quiet girl with a loud voice. Don't be fooled by her shyness. She plans to surprise the judges with her performance tonight. She hails from the community of Unity on the east coast of Demerara.
Everything okay? Okay, we'll take it one more time from the top.
You know, the thing is, my heart says, let's do this until you get it right. But then again, my heart also reaches out to these other contestants who I wouldn't give that many chances to either. We've given you 3 chances. Just for my own curiosity, what was the reason you kept stopping? I really want to know.
I don't know.
You don't know why you stopped?
You don't know.
See, that also doesn't help me to give you another chance. No.
Yeah.
I'm giving you an out here by asking for an explanation, and your explanation is, I don't know.
Okay, Sasha. Thank you, huh?
Thank you so much.
Let's go.
You can take your seat.
It is time for a break. Keep watching. We'll be right back with Emerging Voices Season 2.
Hi, I'm Chelsea Edgel, your National Honor 21 and Women's Champion 2016. And when I'm off the court, I drink the juice of champions, Sunburst.
Sunburst Juice is manufactured by Continental Foods Inc.
E-Network's Orange Box. Extra, extra, hear all about it. E-Network's Orange Box. Everyone is trying to find out about it. Channels pay one time. No monthly fees, ain't that sublime? Movies, sports, everything you need. So maximize your cable life with E-Network's Orange Box. Everybody wants that brand new Orange Box.
The Orange Box is back in stock. Pick it up at Star Computer, Gizmos and Gadgets, NP Electronics, and Electronic City today.
Season round two. Our next contestant is Karmchand Sugrim. Karmchand is the last to take the stage, and according to him, patience is not his best attribute, but he's not leaving until he performs tonight.
के बताए जो है यन कही जो है यन सुनी वो बात क्या है बता मितवा कहे दर कहने तुझसे क्या मितवा ये खुद से तो ना तो छुपा
I thought it was good. The thing that I want you to be careful of, though, is all these things that you were doing, I could tell you were trying to do it a little to kind of get us reacting. And this man was definitely reacting, and so was I, but we reacted the first time. And then the second and third and fourth time you did it, it wasn't as impactful. So when you do stuff, I gave this example before. It's like putting too much makeup on or wearing too much jewelry. At some point, it's just kind of like, oh, God. Yeah. Sometimes it's like, oh, that's pretty nice. Oh, that's so cute. Oh, that's nice. I like that. Whatever, right? It's like accents. So similarly, when you're singing a song, you do it in like one or two spots. It's like, wow, that was unbelievable. But if you do it in every spot, it's like, wow, he just really did that a lot. So I want you to be really careful because, like I said, with great power comes great responsibility or whatever they say in Spider-Man. Similarly, be careful of that. Otherwise, good job, man. I'll give you another like on it.
Thank you. All right, Mr. Kanji boy. I'm a Kanji man myself, you know. You know, when you're singing and you're building up the song step by step, you know, this song is like that. It kind of like starts from a low point and it builds its way up to that chorus, you know? And that's where, when you bring it there, then it's like, oh, wow. This is the chorus, and then you can enjoy it because you've been building it up slowly, slowly, slowly. And then for you, in this case, whenever you got to the chorus, that's when you were doing all your variations. You couldn't wait to do them, and you were doing it, you know, a little too much, just like Jeffrey said, you know. But just take it easy and start to save it for the end. You know, you don't give it all one time. All right. Other than that, great job, man.
Don't give it all up in the beginning.
Yeah, don't give it all up in the beginning. Life lesson right there.
It's a life lesson.
Don't give it up.
Take
all
it as many meanings as you want out of it, but don't give it all away in the beginning. Wait until the time is right, and then you give it.
Wait.
I mean, I completely agree with them. I mean, it was there, but you just have to make those moments special. And you know, don't do all of it all the time. You know, keep it for the punchline. Keep it for the punchline. But I think, I mean, it's your first episode, and listening to you and this song, I think it's a difficult song to sing, and you did a really, really good job with it. So, you know, take the lessons, take the take-home points, and as they said, not all, not at once. You know, keep it simple. Sometimes less is more.
The judges have made their decisions, and now I'd like to call the 9 participants on stage. Give it up for them. Now that we have our participants here, this is the elimination round. Over to the judges.
So we've come to the worst part of the night, which is the elimination part. But sadly, we have to do this because there can only be one emerging voice amongst everyone. I'm going to first call the top 5. When I call your name, you can have a seat over there. Take a deep breath. You've moved on to the next round. Dharamraj. Vidya.
Shivanand. 2 more to go. Karamchand. And Jeffrey, you want to reveal the last name?
Riaz.
One elimination is pretty obvious tonight, and it breaks our heart to have to say this, but Sasha, I'm sorry. The journey ends here for you tonight. You have discipline, you have dedication, and you love to sing. Never let that change. So I wish you very, very good things going forward. See it as a growth curve. See it as a learning experience. And, you know, whatever you do, keep on singing.
Song selection is super important. Don't pick super difficult songs, because this is the reason that you're at the bottom 3. You picked a song that was way, 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 way too difficult. And I think you need to pick songs that you can nail and eventually work up to the place where you can do these extremely difficult songs.
There was a few things there that, you know, you could have fixed. You know, I know you were thinking a lot because you never performed with a band before as much, but that's what this is all about. It's about that experience. So I want you to keep it going, keep learning, keep singing. That's all that matters. And of course, you're part of a bigger movement, which is, you know, suicide awareness. I want you to keep doing that work. You're doing a great job.
That's amazing.
So the contestant ending their journey today, only on the show though, not with music. Maya, thank you so much for sharing your voice with us.
And it's a beautiful voice.
It is
a very, very, very beautiful. We all agree on that.
And you've got an amazing smile and spirit. It's going to take you very far, I'm telling you. Everyone, please give Maya a round of applause.
Tonight, the journey ended for some of you. But like has been emphasized throughout this episode and will be emphasized throughout the competition, singing is a passion that never dies. It's a part of you. And if you think of your voice as a part of you, as a big part of you, not separate, then I think you will always sing. But for those of you who are moving forward, it gets tougher.
That's right, winner. So this is not a time to relax. It's not like, oh my God, okay, we got here. Time to go. Now it's really, you need to pick it up, focus, get good rest, and we'll see you in the next round.
Until next week, I'm Taruna Tiwari. Goodbye.